So, we've come down to a charity gig in aid of mine.
Mine?
Mental health charity. Mine, the best charity in town. And I'm here, and I'm joined by Zak Abel. I was there in the park. I'm exhausted. We've got a fucking show to do.
The pot has been adequately stirred.
Loads of questions with them. I feel like we're already so energetically
ready.
I heard that you're insane at ping pong.
Yeah, I used to be very good at ping pong. Table tennis. Not ping pong. Table tennis.
Table tennis. Which club game?
Where? Now?
Oh, right now. Yeah, go.
Air table tennis. Eyes closed. Did it go on?
Oh, I headed it.
Oh, you can't do that.
Unstable. It's been huge.
I did a little performance in Sweden. Unstable. One in Finland. Going to Germany soon.
So, in all seriousness, Zak, why are we really here? My mental health charity. Fabulous charity. Thank you so much for supporting it.
I think mental health is something which not many people know much about, and when you're having some difficulties with your mental health, it's also quite difficult to reach out. So to know that there is a service available to you or some people that actually care,
yes,
that's something that's worth having in the world. So I 100% stand behind it,
yes,
and I'm doing what I can to support it.
Coming back to me.
Sort of
being bare and
being
naked and all
sorts. Yeah, I mean, exactly that. The title is about being unfiltered, being real with people. So, yeah, it actually came from a song on the album called Only When We're Naked, which is about wanting to be real with people that you're, either friends with or in a relationship with, or when you're on stage with me. I want to be real with the audience, with people listening to my music. So, yeah, it kind of made sense to call the album Only When We're Naked to represent my music. I want it to be honest, I want it to be real and open.
Honesty is the best policy. Happy road, mate.
Yeah. Yeah, I was there.
Oh, somebody went to, can you do the light?
I did do that. I felt really, really touristy when I did it, but I was like, you know what? I'm out of
here. Sorry, can we just for the camera get there? Can I do it that you want? There you go, no. Look at that, that's a photo finish right there. Did you feel like the kind of, the air of legends?
I did.
Or is it more just a studio that's got a big name?
Well, I think it's a bit of both. Some amazing legends recorded there. I think it was Studio 2 that the Beatles recorded about 150 songs or something in that room. I could have got that wrong. Apologies if you work there and I've got it wrong. But,
copyright.
Yeah. So I just saw someone I know. Right. Come in.
Go, fans.
Good singer. Watch out.
Say your name, say it to the camera.
Tell you, run.
You heard it here, man. He's got so many fans, motherfucker.
Oh, hang on.
No, it's
cool. This guy is going to be huge. Holy fuck.
You can't say that. It's a charity gig. Charities don't swear.
So sorry. But it's such a good card.
I'm so sorry.
He's loving happiness, y'all.
Huge gig coming up in October.
That hasn't been announced yet.
It's cool. Get down to see this guy. So we're having an acoustic set here, but there you're going to be like, full band, whole thing.
So yeah, we'll be full band. So you have some drums, you have some guitar, you have some piano, you have some booths, which is backing vocalists. That's going to be a great time. We're all obviously going to get naked and
everyone's getting naked.
Just run around and just have everything be free.
Sadly, at this gig, we do have to keep, you know, clothes on, charity cake and all that, namaste. But,
surely namaste would be clothes off.
Oh, shit, it's so good.
Namaste.
Oh,
sorry, namaste.
Zach, it's been a dream. You have a job
I'm
today.
Sure.
Namaste. Let's go, shut up. I can hear the fans going, pick up Zak Abel, the biggest, baddest, new one, the perfect thing in town. Jeez.